over my top 10 layouts for 2019. These are not in the particular order, like 1 through 10. They're actually just in chronological order from my album, so that way I can put them back because it's the order in which I did complete them in 2019. There were a bunch others, but like I said, I wanted to keep it to top 10, and so let's go through them. So this one I did, actually, I'm actually terrible at date stamping. I have to make that like a resolution for 2020 to like stamp date my layouts, because then I never know what time of day of the year it was when I did this one. But anyway, this one was beautiful. This one I actually used, I think it was Horizon? It might not have been Horizon, but it was Paige Evans. Paige Evans pattern paper for a collection that had nothing but hexagons on it, and I individually cut all of them. So that was the pattern paper, and then I folded in two corners, and the opposite side was the striped corner, and then that's how I got the dimensional hexagon dimension for this layout. It just turned out beautiful. The detail too, I even used modeling paste with the honeycomb pattern, and then I had Spiegelmom scraps, I think it was called Hexagon Love, and I actually had some hexagon wood veneer from my stash as well. So the whole hexagon thing got carried out nicely throughout this layout. I really do like the way it came out. And you know, even my title was simple with this XOXO metallic. And the pictures, too, were just extra outtakes from our holiday photo shoot for our Christmas cards last year. This, and for that one, I do believe there is a process video on my channel. Actually, I think there is a process video for all of these on my channel. This one was a guest designer spot for the CheekyStudio.com. They are an online store to buy die cuts, sequins, and embellishments for your layouts. And so I was sent, I believe this was called the Winter Flower Pack. And I'll be honest, I probably used the entire Winter Flower Pack on this layout. So this layout was costly. I did use the sequins embellishments. There are some splatters, and then I adorned all the flowers on this reef cut file that I did on my Silhouette Cameo. This wood veneer too was from the Cheeky Studio as well. I just colored it, painted it black, and picture Valentina and Zoe under the Christmas tree from last year. This was a layout that I did for a YouTube hop for Spiegelmom Scraps as well as Scrappy Studio. She is the owner that does the epoxy flare buttons, and so I was sent these 1 through 8. Actually, I think it was 1 through 10 in the pack, but I used through the 8, and I did 8 little happy moments with Valentina. This is a cut file, I do believe, from Paige Evans as well, and I backed it with mint green pattern paper, and then pattern paper. This was a Maggie Holmes one that was marbled, and then the inside ones was from a Valentine sheet from Michael's Craft Store, I believe. And then the sequences are all from Spiegelmom Scraps, and then some of the heart and conversation things, I believe these were from Target Dollar Spot, believe it or not. I just love the simplicity of this one, even though it packs a punch with the mint and the pink. And when I was sent the number flares, I really was stuck from it. I was like, what am I supposed to do with this? Like, normally I would save numbers for like December daily or like week in the life, and so I had to think really, and I forgot who I had gotten the idea from, but in essence that's how I was able to use the numbers very effectively for this layout. This one was a scrap lift from Paige Evans. I copied her pinwheel dimensional goodness. Oh my god. I did this layout. It was a scrap lift from Paige Evans, but I did this one for the scrapbookingstore.com. This was their like spring kit, and I just love the colors of like the pink, the blue, the apple green, and the yellow. And then this, I love the way these pattern striped ones came out. And then I added like some buttons that were in my stash. These were also like additions or like tissue flowers. The title was from a sticker page from that collection. And just a little Valentina, a little outfit, and then gold splatter and yellow splatter. But this is very dimensional. This sits in my album as the only layout in the page protector because it's so chunky, y'all. But I love it. I definitely want to try this one again. Maybe not as many pinwheels, but definitely having a cluster of pinwheels would be cute to show off a collection. This one, I think, was one of the first ones I did with the Maggie Home Sunny Days collection. I took the time, if you know the collection, there is a sheet of seashell paper, a paper that has nothing but seashells, and I fussy cut each and every one out of that paper, and it, some of them were gold foiled, and then I cut out, I was actually going to do it the opposite way, but in essence, this beachy paper, I cut this big circle out of first, and then the pool paper, a littler circle, and I think I was going to do the opposite ways, like I was looking, thinking of rings, but as I took off the negative and positive spots on what I was going to cut, I think maybe because I was using the inside, so this would have been the beachy one, and then this one, but I actually liked having the white gap is how this one like came to be, and then I just kept the corners of the beachy one, and I just simply adore how this one came out. This one was a labor of love. I actually did a lot of labor of love layouts last year. I fussy cut a ton on layouts to get the details. The payout is always great. And then the chipboard was from the chipboard collection too. I think I really did finish the Sunny Days collection. I bought everything in it, and I think I only have like six or so of the 12x12s, and then like everything else, maybe a couple stickers, but everything else was used. Throughout the course of the year, I got Sunny Days and annihilated Sunny Days last year. This one was just for me. I don't think this was actually, no, this one was for a design team for Spiegel Mom Scraps at the time. Again, I fussy cut out all of these. These were from an old Paige Evans pattern paper, probably one of her first collections. I had it in my stash forever. I didn't know what to do with it. And then since I was in this fussy cutting year, I fussy cut them all out. And the thing that I did too was actually layer like another cut file behind it that is kind of like a lattice little pattern, but I did it on white, and I kind of just like the added texture you can see in the back area. And at first too, the baby pink that you see was actually a cut file of all like these daisies, but it just added some interest here, and like you can see some of the daisies, but it was like a ring of daisies, and then all of it on top of it just covered most of it up. It just peeks through here and there, which is fine. And then the sequence, you can see there's like dimensional little flower pieces and stuff. That is from the sequence pack from Spiegel Mom Scrap Store. I forgot the name of that one, but that one was fun. I think it was like Hibbity Hoppity or something. It was from the spring line. And then this was a Maggie Holmes puffy sticker. And then I think this one was from a Chamel collection. And then just Valentina rocking some glasses at the time. I really like how that one came out. Another cut file. I don't think I scrapped. It was just a cut file. What I did was make my own layered heart embellishments here. So I have this, the heart punches in all these different sizes, and a few of the layers are just vellum. So that was because once I had it, the cut file backed, I was like, what am I going to embellish with this? Like, I'm not working with the collection. And so I made my own kind of big embellishments and just kept the simple title. And this one's really cute. This is a picture of me and my Miguel and Valentina from Easter. And I think I told everyone too, I'm like, I love their little like laughing moment, and I'm the only one like really smiling at the camera, you know, but it was still just adorable little moment captured right there for Easter. That's that one. I scraplifted this one once again from Paige Evans. She is one of my inspirational muses all the time. She did a monochromatic layout. Hers was in yellow, but it was the same cut file. And I think I just used, this was actually just a paper pad from Michaels. So I think it was like just obviously a blue tone paper pad that worked well to back the cut file up. Hello Cutie was a thicker collection. I believe this was Maggie Holmes, but it could be Vicky Booten. I'm not sure. Don't hold me to that. That little dragonfly. Actually, it could be Kaiser Craft, too. These are definitely Kaiser Craft. I've had them in my collection for a while. And then I adorned it, too, with like a little flare button and some ribbon. This is really cute, and I really like the way it came out. Everything always has I love sequins to finish off layouts. So you can see the sprinkling of some blue and iridescent ones. Just a fun picture of Valentina, but it's just a monochromatic. Again, another kind of style. I need to do a monochromatic layout again. Like this came, I did a few last year, but this blue one was definitely a standout one for me. And again, scrap lifted from the lovely Paige Evans, so that one was fun. This one, There is a, actually, no, I think I didn't do a process video because I thought it was going to be so boring for you. But in essence, it's a Paige Evans cut file. I cut it out on peach colored cardstock. And then I truly just went in with Spiegel Mom Scraps sequences and detailed the entire thing. And then the gold is Nouveau Drops that I dotted up. And like, I was like literally sitting here for maybe like an hour to do this side and then an hour to do this side. When I was looking at the footage, I was like, I would speed through all of this and just kind of show you like what I was doing. And then it would have been like a minute long. Granted, I should have maybe done something. So at this one, I think there is no cut process video for, but it was a, like I said, a very simple technique in my opinion, but just it's detail oriented. And then the embellishments, I do believe these are all from Flourish. There could have been a couple add-ons, or maybe not just Flourish, but like a couple of Maggie Home collections in general. This fabulous, and I did the same on the bottom. You can see all the detail, and you had to let it dry. And then it was photos from my Mother's Day photo shoot. That's what I wanted for Mother's Day, so I got some really good photos of me and Valentina. Because if you're a parent, you always know that you're behind the camera taking great photos of everyone else, and sometimes there's lacking of you in your own photos. So that's Mother's Day for me. So those were great photos. And then this is the last one. You know, the only thing looking back on it now I wish I did was around these corners. I used this again the other day on my layout that's just viewed. And I think it's the only thing that makes the, like, because it's all like soft and rounded edges because of the hearts. And I wish that maybe these were rounded. It's just a small detail. But other than that, the cut file is from me. It was a class I took in big picture classes, and it was offered as a cut file, and it came as a 10 layered heart thing, and it was supposed to be done like in rainbow colors. I just cut out three of the layers, and I did it on like a peach cardstock, a rose gold glitter cardstock is the inside layer, and then like a true coral in the back, and then Nouveau dots in the center. The cluster is, I think these are Heidi Swap. This is like the oldest collection ever. It's, I don't remember. I have Project Life cards in it, but they were old flowers. These stickers were from an Amy Tangerine set, and this was a picture I took with me, my mom, my sister. We went to the J-Lo concert this evening, so it was a fun photo. We were all wearing black and white, and we went out for the girls' night, and then just some, I think it's like, it looks like gray splatters, but it's really just a simple layout. What I will say, what I've noticed about my style last year is that I didn't do a lot of mixed media. I kept my style, actually, in my opinion, compared to what I used to do all the time, very more simple in my eyes. I used a lot of cut files, which I do like. It takes some of the work and layout choosing away from you. I did a lot of fussy cutting, which is different, but like I said, the work is worth it because your layouts become quite remarkable in that regard. Maybe worked on more composition, I would say. But it's definitely, like I said, like there's really, like, other than splatters on most, there's literally no mixed media. It's just a crisp style I had last year, and I kind of like where that's going for me. It's good to change a little bit, you know, or see what works or what's your go-to style. And I will say, too, I noticed I did last year a lot of wreaths, you know, so anything that was in a circular composition, even with the cut files, I also saw kind of a trend with a lot of my photos and layouts that the wreath or circular layout was definitely prominent for me. I mean, even though it's just a wreath. So maybe my wreath is my thing, you know, that's going to be fun. So do stay tuned. I am trying to, you know, get a little bit more footage filmed on what I'm doing. I will have a Project Life flip through next because I know I've missed filming them since July. So I have July through December to kind of flip through. I probably won't talk as much, but more show you layout spreads and maybe let you know where product came from. That'll be the next video. So thank you so much for joining me. Let me know which was your favorite layout out of these. I'd like to know, and let's have a good 2020. I'm so excited for all of our scrappy creativity that's going to start coming out of all of us. Have a good day, everyone. Bye.